Hey, good morning. Welcome to Louisiana Outdoor Adventures TV. I'm Kevin Ford. Beautiful morning in Delacroix in St. Bernard Parish. We've got Captain Joe Ezell up front pulling in a redfish. Marshman Masson, Todd Masson's with us as well. We're going to stay in the marsh today, catch some fall reds down here in St. Bernard Parish, and you're going to see it all today on Louisiana Outdoor Adventures TV. What you got, Joe? Get him.
Nice.
Tell folks a little bit about what we're doing here. We're in a canal, and how are we set up?
What we've done, over the last 3 or 4 weeks, the tide's been abnormally high in Delacroix, and in the last 4 or 5 days, it started to fall back out. So what that's done is it's pulled these fish back off of these marshes and new areas where they've been roaming back into these deeper canals and bayous. And what we've noticed over the last 2 weeks is these fish are locating on grass beds, and actually they're actually using that as the bank edge now. And they're on the grass beds on the up current side where it terminates back into the bank. That's where the schools are concentrating currently. So that's what we're fishing.
There you go.
Oh.
Oh, nice.
Feels like a keeper.
It feels like a
Delacroix special.
Yeah.
We refer to him as tacos. He's a fish taco.
That was a close one.
Oh, he's in.
Yeah, that's a good one.
Oh, yeah.
Nice redfish.
He's in.
So, when you get out here, one of the things you like to do is, Joe used to like target bass, and he used to be a bass fisherman.
Right.
So, we were talking a few minutes ago about what you do, and you kind of look at patterning fish when you fish, and talk about what you do as far as doing that.
That's exactly what I do. And when I start the morning, I target these fish. So the first fish we catch, I pay very close attention to how we catch it. Was it on a point, left side of the point, right side of the point? Was it in a cut? Was it in a pocket? Was it a foot off the bank, 5 feet off the bank, 10 feet off the bank? Was I popping the cork slow or fast? Whenever I figure that out, I remember that and keep it in the back of my mind. We catch a second fish that same way, then I know I'm on the pattern, and I start replicating that all over the marsh the rest of the day until the pattern changes. It's a dynamic environment. That pattern can change throughout the day as the wind changes, current changes. There's several things that can happen. So really, the message is be attentive to how you're catching the fish, not so much how many you're catching. Pay attention to how you're catching them. And if you replicate that throughout the day, you'll be much more successful.
Oh, that's a good one there, buddy. Yes, indeed. Real nice red. Well, okay. You talk about patterning the fish. You put that thing right back where you threw it a minute ago.
Yeah, he's there on the corner of that grass bed.
And one thing I'm noticing here, Joe, is these fish are right on those grass beds.
Yeah, and that's the other thing that we've noticed too. They've been right on the edge of that grass line, so they're treating that like the bank. A lot of what I think they're doing is they're staying under that grass to ambush coming back out. Because like we talked about before, in my opinion, these things act a lot like a bass. And one of their primary ways to feed is they're an ambush predator.
Yep. That's a big fish. I'll get the net for you. Let me get it. Ooh, pretty. The thing about these things is you don't want to put your line down. But that is a big red. Whoops, there we go. That's a fat Delacroix St. Bernard redfish. Oh!
Uh-oh.
That's why I said you don't want to put your line down. Uh-oh. Do I have Todd?
I think you do.
All right.
Boss, we got the fish.
No, I don't have Todd.
Better fish, Kevin?
Yeah, good fish.
Yeah, better fish.
Yeah, real good fish. But yeah, that's what I was talking about a minute ago while I was holding the net. You know, I was trying to be funny, but really and truly, it's not, that is a serious thing. When you are fishing out here,
never set it down.
And if you have just any sort of bait on your line and there's redfish in the area, don't set it down. Oh God, this is just so much fun to do this. This, oh yeah, baby.
You got Joe's twin, huh?
Yep. That's
what he's got.
All right, come on. Not quite a twin, but he's pretty. All right. Awesome. Boy, he swallowed it too.
Good.
All right.
Got him.
There we go.
There he is.
Nice red. So we're sticking and moving just down this bank.
There's another one. We got us a double.
Todd's got one in the back. Pretty fish.
Double.
Double trouble. All right.
Sure, mine's
we'll get mine in.
No, I got a sheep.
Yep. The variety continues. Sheephead on one end of the boat and a big old fat red on the other. God, look how fat these redfish are. Amazing. What is in this fish's belly?
The best eating fish we'll catch today. No doubt.
Well, there's no.
People don't know it. People throw these back.
Not me.
Now look at this fish. Look at the belly on this thing. I mean, that fish is, see if we can hold it this way. This fish, I mean, he ate something, Joe.
Oh yeah, a lot of something.
He ate a lot of something, but that is a fat redfish.
When I've been cleaning these guys in these canals, a lot of what's been in them, they're on a lot of mullet, a lot of larger mullet, and a lot of crab.
Yeah,
a lot of crab.
So what we're doing now is we're just kind of been moving up the shoreline a little bit and just fishing the same pattern, just fishing right on top of the grass, but you're moving. It seems like you catch, you know, you're going to move, catch a couple of them in one spot, catch three of them in one spot,
correct.
Maybe go to a couple of spots, not catch any.
Correct.
So don't spend a lot of time. If you're not catching fish, don't spend a lot of time.
No, it's a stick and move thing. And like we talked about this morning, they're at the edges of these grass beds where they terminate into the bank on the up current side. So we're moving down this canal 50, 75, 100 yards at a time, making three or four casts. Nothing happens. Get up and move. 10 minutes, move. If you don't get bit in four casts, they're not there. Move. You've got to move. That's the deal.
Yeah. Yeah, sitting on fish is trying to sit in and make them bite is not the thing. Now, we've caught them on a variety of baits today. Live shrimp is, we've got a bunch of Campos live shrimp today, and we're using them and fishing those, and we'll show you the setup here in a minute. Well, actually, the setup is really pretty kind of easy here. Got a Fitzgerald rod, 7-foot spinning rod with a stunner reel on it, fishing with Versa braid, and then I've just got a fishing with a 4-horseman cork with our fluorocarbon leader and an 1/8 ounce death grip jig head. I just fish with the real light ones, and you can put a live shrimp on that for these redfish. So real simple, real easy way to catch them. And that's a big old fat red. All right, here you go.
I got it.
Oh, you got it.
He got him.
Todd got him.
I don't have him yet. I mean, let's think of the last fish.
But you're getting him.
He's on the way to the boat.
God, what did you get a diver to get that fish? I mean, he didn't even fight.
Dude, look at that. He did not.
That fish.
It's a Kevin Ford of fish.
See, exactly my point. Exactly my point.
But he's going to eat well because he is legal.
Oh,
yeah. Oh, yeah.
All day.
Yeah, he's legal.
Great fish.
He is great. I tell you another thing that we're noticing with these fish today is a lot of times when we catch these fish down here, guys, they're just this golden, they have that golden red color, but the water's a little bit off today. So with the water being off, these fish aren't as dark. I mean, these fish have been in this muddier water, and they're not that golden today.
Yeah, if you're throwing bait, it really doesn't matter. Like Joe was saying earlier, actually, this water is better if you're throwing bait than throwing in clear water.
Yeah.
If you're fishing lures, obviously, you want to find the best water you can, but a situation like this, who cares that they're not pretty?
They are just still
delicious.
Yeah, correct. They do. But that's a nice...
Pretty enough.
Yeah, it is pretty enough. Gonna have an oh, there we go.
There he is.
Get him, Kevin.
What is that?
What is you that got, Kevin?
I don't know. I think I have a sheep head.
Oh, that's a redfish.
That's a redfish. He was just kind of acting a little funny. Where is he at? There he is. A little red. A fat redfish.
He is a little golden, isn't he?
He is a little golden. He's got some spots on him. Look how pretty.
Good eater.
That's a pretty redfish. All right. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. See, we did a spot contest today for like thousands of dollars.
So let's. You got that sewn up.
1, 2, 3, 4. I think we have 4 spots on that side. And on this side, I think we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 9 spotted. So 9 spots is to beat. But what a pretty redfish. And just going in these canals and working in these canals. And Joe, it's just been, it's really just, it's been a real consistent morning in that it's consistent in that we'll stop at a couple of places and not get a fish and then stop at a couple of places and get some fish.
Right.
So it's just, we continue to stick and move in here. And these fish, one thing about the Delacroix area is it's a year-round fishery.
That's correct, it is.
So these fish will be here, but this is a really good time of year in the fall to catch these fish,
right,
isn't it?
Right, right. And the canal pattern, that's what I call it, in this 8, 10, 12 foot of water and fishing these flats up on the edges, it's a natural place for them to seek a safe haven in the winter as the temperatures drop down. Because what they want to do is in the mornings as the sun comes up, they're going to push onto these flats to feed, because that the shallow water on these mud flats is going to warm faster than the deeper water. But they also want the safety to be able to drop back down to the deep water at night when the temperature drops. It's going to stay warmer, deeper, longer at night. So it's a very good late fall winter pattern to replicate all over the marsh in Delacroix.
Yeah, that's a really good point to make, is that these canals that we're fishing in are deep.
That's correct.
And that's what people need to know. There's a lot of deep canals down here. And really, as you get into the wintertime too, where we're sitting in these deep canals are good speckled trout spots.
Phenomenal. Yeah. Phenomenal. Any edge or eddy or any turn or break in this canal where you get current push around a point,
that's
a great example right there. You can back down to this bank and throw off of it, and it'll be a great trout spot in the winter.
So yeah, these spots are really great year-round redfish a lot, and then certain times of the year you can get in here and catch reds and specks and reds with 9 spots.
How the Pros Do It is brought to you by Demco, your Touchtone Energy Cooperative.
All right, look, we got into this spot, and we've got 2 or 3 fish that have hit. And a lot of days what I will do, especially when the bite's a little slow or the fish seem a little sluggish, I keep bait from the last 2 or 3 days, because we're a charter fishery and, you know, fishermen, and we run a lot of live bait or dead bait trips. What I've noticed with these fish, when they're a little slow or a little sluggish, if you catch a couple, if you'll throw some old chum onto the spot, not necessarily will it bring more fish to you, but whatever's in this area, it will hold them there so you can cast on them repeatedly. Because what I've noticed is whenever you make 4, 5, or 6 casts into an area bombing corks on them, you're subject to blow the fish out. But if there's a lot of shrimp in the area, a lot of smell, a lot of scent, they seem to recover quicker. So it keeps them in the area so that you have a chance to catch them. So we do that a lot to try and up our numbers on certain spots to get the limit quicker in the boat.
Got him, Joe?
Yeah.
Ooh, good one, buddy.
Oh, a drag ripper.
Nice. Oops, he's by my quirk.
Get in.
Get my quirk in.
Kevin, you down?
No, I'm just...
Getting out the way?
I'm in the way. All right. Made a move to a little bay, a little bit more open water. Tide's not going in the right direction right now for us. So we're sticking and moving a little bit, but it looks like this is a good move because that is a nice fish. that you got there, buddy. Joe, there's just so many options you have
there out
here.
There really
are. And that's one of the great things about fishing down here in St. Bernard Parish, besides the fact that, you know, we were talking a little bit earlier about one of the great things for people that come in town on conventions and everything. You're so close to New Orleans, and for people that want to come in and go fishing, boy, this is the place to come, isn't it?
Yeah, absolutely. No doubt about it. Yeah, we had to go with him.
Yeah. Yep, so he's going to come back this way.
Yeah, he's going to go where he wants. That's what he's going to do.
Whew, man. That's a bull rat. And we catch those too.
Yeah, we get those too.
But that is not one that, that's not one that we're going to have for dinner. That's one that you can come down here and come on Whiskey Bayou Charters with Captain Joe Ezell and come back and catch him. What a big redfish.
It's a good one.
Yeah. Well, there's your, I was about to say, can't see your hook, but there it is.
Yeah, it's there.
It is there.
It's there.
Pretty fish. Yeah, this is very much brackish water area that we're in as you fish over here, because it's...
Absolutely.
I mean, this area is very much affected by the Mississippi River.
Oh, yeah.
And the water's getting a little bit dirty right now. The river's on the rise again. Normally, this time of year, Mississippi River is really not high at all. It's real low and the water's clean, but we're having a rise and water's a little stained. But one thing about these redfish is it doesn't bother them. You can catch these redfish in this stained water. And that's the other thing that's
absolutely
really, really good about our fishery down here is you don't need, now you're gonna have to bring bait with you, but you don't need to have just crystal clear water. And these fish are used to dealing with these
correct
adverse conditions sometimes with
correct
this water.
And that's another thing that makes the fishery unique, and it makes it a good place to come. You don't have to have, you can deal with adverse conditions and water conditions and weather too. We got a lot of wind today, you know. We got a high pressure system and a cold front on us. But the estuary is so rich. There's so many different options. It just book the trip. I mean, you're going to catch.
Yeah. You're going to come down here and catch, and you're going to do it 12 months a year. I mean,
right,
that's the other thing. You can come in here and you can catch these redfish 12 months a year. The reds and the bass are a staple all year long. So we're going to put that big girl back, and I'd say let her grow up, but I don't think she needs to grow up anymore.
I think she's grown.
But let her make some babies.
Exactly. Exactly. This is a broodstock. We never want to keep these.
No, you don't want to keep those. So we'll put that one back and see if we can catch another one.
Hello ATV is brought to you by Ralph Sellers, Chrysler Dodge Jeep and Ram in Gonzales, Louisiana's number one Ram dealer. Welcome back to Louisiana Outdoor Adventures TV. Well, after Joe catches this big bull red, we're now on the edge of a bay, but fishing a grass line, and we don't catch a fish. And all of a sudden, all heck breaks loose. Folks, I'm telling you, the fish started coming in one after another to where we couldn't hardly keep up. It was redfish after redfish, all of them about the same size, 17, 18 inches, but it was amazing. We went from catching a bull red to nothing, and then this happens, catching all of these fish at once. And that's what can happen when you're fishing for these redfish. You can get a school of them move through, or they can just start to bite. And boy, when they start biting, you can have a lot of fun out here. And we are ending this day on just an epic redfish bite fishing with Captain Joe Ezell. And I tell you, you can't have any more fun than casting your line out, and before you can click the bail, almost your cork is under and you're reeling a redfish in.
Well, while you come, why don't you come up here, Todd? Come join us. I gotta tell everybody, as you're catching this fish, we're running out of time with this show. So this would be a perfect time and an opportunity to land this beautiful redfish.
Oh, that's a big
one.
And
to tell you to come down here to St. Bernard Parish and come fishing, because it's great. 12 months out of the year, we're close to the French Quarter, close to New Orleans, and this guy, Captain Joe Ezell, great charter captain, Whiskey Bayou Charters. And if you want to learn about fishing in South Louisiana, we got to get you on the side so you can see here. And this is TV.
He's still fishing.
And he's still fishing, trying to do a close, and he's not even paying attention.
Check
out Marshman Mass on YouTube. And he fishes down here a lot. Look at his videos, subscribe, and you can learn a lot about how we catch the fish down here. Thanks again, Captain Joe. It's been an outstanding day. Todd, as always, man, we enjoy fishing with you.
Catch you, Todd.
Thanks to Jim Caesar for producing the show.
All right, Todd Masson. Great job, Jim.
Todd Masson's going to reel in a redfish. And there is no better way to end a South Louisiana day of fishing than with a big redfish on your
line.
Coming
in the boat.
Thanks for joining us. Y'all have a great day, because we certainly are going to continue to have one catching these redfish here in Delacroix, St. Bernard Parish. Ooh, that's a nice one, buddy.
Here, thank you.
Fish. Is he a netter?
No, I mean, for Todd, he's a netter.
No, I mean, Todd's going to swing this fish.
Biggest red of my life. Come on.